Google Drive. See, Google Drive and Google Doc is something which we know since eternity. Ever since we know Google, no? Google Drive, Google Doc, and stuff, we just know that they do exist. But we actually never went out and explored them. Because it is into the art that you just don't know about stuff, you need to explore things. Right? You know, opening Google Drive is easy. All you have to do is open a new tab, right? Go to your Google Drive. That's easy, I guess. Now when you open the Google Drive, this is the icon for Google Drive. Right? Login to your Google Drive. Aap jab kholenge Google Drive, you'll have, since I've already logged in, I've been doing certain work here. What I want to tell you is that you have, there will be an option where you need to log in with your Google Drive. You understand this thing? Every Gmail account you make, they give you a certain amount of free space in the cloud where you can store your docs, your images, your photographs, whatever you have. So for that reason, so you need to know where you're working, you know? Google needs to know where you want to work. So the first and the foremost important thing is you need to sign in. Right? Once you sign in, you can see a lot of options there. There's My Drive, which shows all the work I've done. Share with me and all the assignments and the work with the other people have sent me. Then there is Recent, which shows all my recent most works. Then there is Start, that is the all the important work which has been done is there. Then is the Trash, which is the bin, which has all the garbage which needs to be thrown out. It's basically the recycle bin of the Google Drive. Now please see, this is the 15 GB space that each Google account gives us. And it is upon us how much we use it. And once it is done, we can buy more storage. And that is not difficult. Another important thing is the Google Drive. Click on the folder and there are lots of folders. This file upload, folder upload, Google Docs. Google Docs is very, very similar to the Google, what the MS Word file we have. Most of the options are absolutely same. The basic difference between the two is, when you write things in your Google, they get saved automatically. Every small change you make, they get saved automatically. Whereas in the Word, you need to keep on pressing the Control S every time. Another thing is the Google Sheets, which is the same as Microsoft Excel. The other one is the Google Slide, which is like the PowerPoint. Now there are various other things as well. There are Google Form, Google Drawings, Maps, Sites, Apps, Jamboard, etc. And I'll deal with all of these simultaneously in one slide each. So this is all about the Google Drive. And my request to you is these things, no, these computer apps, I once again repeat that they are like maths. The more you practice, the more you know. There we know 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 exist. But if you don't keep on practicing addition, one on two doing karna kabhi na, you have to draw one line, another one drawing one line, and that is what happens.
No, another important thing is Google Docs, right?
So we go to new. Now we go to Google Docs, and I said Google Docs is very, very similar to the Microsoft Word which we have already worked in. You see the same option. File, edit, view, insert, format, tools, and add-ons is something we'll talk. And help. When we open file, we have an option share. I'll show you something. Like I write here, welcome to my class. As simple as that. The minute I wrote welcome to my class, it automatically saved in a title called untitled document. You can change the name of the document, and that can be whatever you want. Suppose I want to write it ACV. Alright, this is in my drive and this is the text. You write something to the text. Hello. And this is this is ABC hello. Alright, come on. I write here hi. You see, it is immediately saved to the drive. I don't have to save it again and again, it is immediately saved to the drive. Next important thing is, please see the font. This is the Arial font. Remember all those fonts we had in Word? Similar. See, this is the font size. Similar. Bold, italics, underline. The pen, etc. is all the similar. Then you can add commands, right? Next, you can insert images. Images, you have to, you know, hunt for it. It is from your computer or from where. Or from the drive, photos, whatever you wanted, you can insert images. Then if you remember the alignment, they are the same. This is left justified, right justified, center justified, and this is the justified one. Then these are indents, the numbered list. So these are the bullets. These are everything are exactly the same. Now, there is one, you see this is the link, insert link. You can write certain link, right? Now, file mein, there is an option, new, open, we know about that. Make a copy is you make, when you make a copy of this document with the name of copy ACV hello is created and saved in the drive itself. Then you can email it as an attachment. Then you can download it. Now download it is what? As Microsoft Docs or open document format. See, this is here where you can obviously convert your Google Doc into PDF form. And these are also saved in the downloads folder of your computer. Then they can be made available offline. There's version history. You can see the current version. You can rename your file. You can move your file to a certain other place. You can add the shortcut to the drive. You can move this to the trash, publish on the web, etc. These are the things you can do. Edit main, they are almost the same things. Undo, redo, paste, etc. View main up, you can see the print mode, ruler, text, exactly the way we heard in Word. Now insert main, there is image from the various places, there is the table, drawing, chart, horizontal line, footnote, headnote, you know from the Word, special characters, headers, footers, breakers, links, same as the Word. Formatting is again similar as Word. Now tools, we have the spelling character, Gangaram, grammar, workout, which counts the number of words in your document, etc. Whatever it is, but just this is the voice typing. Voice typing is again similar to one we have in the Word. When you have, there is an option of speech recognition in the Word, where you can, the way you speak is totally written down. This voice typing is exactly the same. All you have to do is make your speech, your Microsoft basically, your computer basically, acquainted with your voice, right? Then there are add-ons. Add-ons are very important things, you know. I have these three add-ons which are not working right now. You know, get add-ons. When you get, try to get add-ons, so there are lots of add-ons. Not open, yeah, it's opening. So you have lots of add-ons. See, you can go for two, you don't have to get everything. So you have to see what is important for you. Because you have to download everything and then they get stored there. If you are a maths teacher, go for maths style. They have lots of formulas, etc. It becomes very easy for you to do that. Then there is the other highlight tool. There is teacher rubric, student rubric, and mail merge, and smart sheets. Lots of stuff are there, which is an add-on, right? These add-ons help you to make your work easier. And you can share. I'll show you. I have to show you how to share. See, this is the share option. You go to share. Once you go to share, they show you the to add the people where you want to share it. Right? So either you write the email address of all the people you want to share with. You write done, and your document is shared with them. And the other process is, they do not give you the email ID. They simply tell you to write the link of the page that is. You have to do is, you have to copy the link. Link copied, right? Now you have to do is, paste the link. See, I'll show you how you paste the link. Wherever they ask you to paste it, not here, but wherever they ask you to paste it, you just paste the link. And whenever that person clicks this link, it will automatically open to this Google Drive. This Google document. This is all about the Google document. I'll tell you about the other features of the Google Drive later. Till then, keep learning, keep sharing, and happy learning. Bye-bye.